Tony Jones was Notre Dame's leading rusher on the team in 2019, and he was kind of one of those bubble guys, whether or not he was going to return for a fifth season. This is Mike Singer, joined by Lou Somogyi, and he opted to take his talents to the NFL, leaving Notre Dame with a void at running back with you know, Jafar Armstrong's the team's career leading rusher at running back, and he only had, what, 100-something yards last season. So going into the 2020 season, Lou, what are you thinking about Notre Dame's running back situation?
The word committee comes to mind again, similar to last season, which was it was anticipated to be there last year too, after the loss of Dexter Williams. So, and that's what you had early in the year. Jameer Smith, he scored the first touchdown. It's like, okay, he's going to be coming along. And Sebo Flemister, he ended up with 5 touchdown rushing, including a crucial one against Virginia. It's like, okay, maybe he's developing. And the whole thought process was that Jafar Armstrong would become a Theo Riddick type of back. But on that opening possession against Louisville, he gets injured in the abdominal region, which is not easy to come back from. So he ends up rushing for less than 150 yards for the season. And not only that, the ones he did rush for, it's only 2.7 yards per carry. Sebo Flemister was limited to 3.4 yards a carry. Jameer Smith ended up as the top rusher among the running backs who are coming back this year. He had 180 yards total. So, because you had Braden Lindsey with 200 yards with the jet sweeps. He had a 51-yard touchdown against USC on a jet sweep, 61 yards against Boston College, average 15.4 yards. So the coaching staff kind of had to be resourceful as far as finding avenues and ways to make that running game function fairly effectively to complement the passing game. And, you know, even with Jameer Smith, even though he's the leading returning rusher from last season in the backfield, Ian Book, of course, had 546. In the last 4 games, Jameer had a total of 7 carries for 0 yards. So little wonder that the running back position is the one that's going to be maybe the most scrutinized as far as who's going to emerge and why Chris Tyree, a top 100 four-star recruit, speedster, is viewed as somebody who would be able to supply some much-needed speed and production to the position.
And Lou, you mentioned freshman running back Chris Tyree is one of those big-name guys that Notre Dame signed in the 2020 class. You know, looking at him, what, 5'9", 5'10", 170, 175 pounds, what would you say his role might be this upcoming fall?
Yeah, I think he was listed at 179 in the December recruiting, but, you know, he missed part of his senior season with an injury. He had about 700 yards rushing. So right away, there's going to be the questions of can he maintain a durability, sustain it throughout an arduous 12-game regular season. I anticipate his role would be a little more expanded version of what we saw from Braden Lindsey as a sophomore last season, because Braden also came in, obviously, as a receiver, not as a running back, but with that reputation of that game-breaking speed. But he was about 170 pounds maybe coming in and was really not ready for that physicality aspect. Now, Chris is a more natural running back. That's where his production has come from. But I don't think they want to overuse him. There's the pass blocking element. There's the receiving element. It's getting him out into space, being able to maybe not use him as much in between the tackles, where he's fine too. I don't see him necessarily as that 15 carry guy, maybe even 10 during the course of the season. If you can get him 5 to 8 touches, I think, per game in space, maybe 5 runs, a couple of screen passes, et cetera, where he could utilize that game-breaking skill, that's where the staff has to be resourceful. in utilizing him, and also Jafar Armstrong and Jameer Smith and Sibo Flemister and Kyren Williams as well. So it's we'll see in August how it can shake out, is whether you can get everybody on the field, find a niche or a role for them.
And Lou, we haven't even mentioned Notre Dame potentially looking at a graduate transfer, Trevor Spates from Stanford. I believe it was as a guy who has 2 years of eligibility. Notre Dame has been in communication with him, but he's not going to be able to visit in March like he had hoped for because of the NCAA enacting a dead period through at least April 15th. So could Notre Dame still add him or somebody else? So that's also a piece of the equation that we'll have to keep an eye on moving forward for Notre Dame at the running back position.